Hi and assalamualaikum. This is our title and this is our group members, and after this we're gonna study.
Before we start to dive into this case study, first of all we need to know about the issue of this case study. But what is the issue of this case study? The issue of this case study is about the impact of volcanic eruptions to environment and health. As we all know, volcanoes are one of the most spectacular and beautiful features of the physical world. But on the other hand, great volcanic eruptions in history time have brought death and destruction to many areas around the world. Every year, people become the victims of eruptions. They also not get killed by pyroclastic flows, mud flows and ash fall, but also because of starvation after crop failures because of volcanic eruptions. And relatively, the small amount of ash can be fatal to animals. After that, let's move on to the goals of this case study. Firstly, the goals of this case study is to be aware of volcanic phenomena because it is important for society today, and the relationship between people and volcanoes is as old as human race. And secondly, is to improve understanding of volcanic processes, guide monitoring efforts, and improve forecast, which means building a volcano science community capable of tackling them.
Causes of the volcanic eruptions. The most common type of eruption is caused by the movement of tectonic plates. When one is pushed under the other magma, sediment and seawater is forced into the chamber, which eventually overflows, and the volcano erupts, spewing lava into the sky. This kind of eruption produces sticky and thick lava at temperatures from 800 to 1000 Celsius. The second one is a decrease in external pressure can trigger an eruption, as it may minimize the volcano's ability to hold back by increasing the pressure inside the magma chamber. This kind of eruption can be caused by natural events such as typhoons. The impact of the volcanic eruptions for the environment and health. There are negative and positive impacts, and I will elaborate first about the negative impact. The first one is toxic gases can cause acid rain and pollution, and it will make the water in the river become toxic. The second one is eruptions occurring close to human settlements may spill and destroy leaf and property. People often have to be evacuated. Then, landscapes and natural sceneries can be destroyed. The last one is regarding human health. Volcanic ash can be very harmful, especially to the elderly people and people with respiratory conditions such as asthma and other chronic lung diseases. They may have problem if they breathe in volcanic ash. Then, I will talk about the positive impact. The first one is please step close to volcanic activities tend to have higher potential for geothermal energy, which can be an advantage to the people. The second one is some ash and lava break down, become soils that are rich with nutrients and become good area for planting activities.
Okay, what alternatives are available to reduce the impact of volcanic eruptions on environment and health? For the better future and to accomplish the goals, scientists should increase their coordination and collaboration with researchers from other parts, other federal agencies, academic institutions, and also private sector. By monitoring the volcanoes before the eruptions, it will reduce the impact of volcanic eruptions to environment and also health. For example, monitoring levels of gas around the volcanoes. Then, by monitoring the movement of tectonic plates and changes in the surface of the volcano, scientists can predict the likelihood of a volcanic eruption and forecast which area should be prepared for one. After that, protection is one of the most challenging aspects of reducing the impact of volcanic eruptions. Lava, flues, lahars and ash fallout cannot be protected against. As a result of this, evacuation is the only real way of reducing the risk associated with volcanic eruptions. The last point, before we end this case study, what would I recommend to reduce the impact of volcanic eruption and why? What we have to do before an eruption? Firstly, if you live near a volcano or plan to visit one, familiarize yourself with the local monitoring agencies. I can take examples from the US Geological Survey's Volcano Notification Service emails information about monitored volcanoes in the United States. Besides that, you have to assemble an emergency kit, and that includes supplies like food, water, respiratory protection, eye protection, and a battery-powered radio. Then, what you have to do during an eruption. During a disaster, be wary of misinformation and try to stick to official source. Moreover, if the authorities instruct you to remain in your own home, just do it and close all windows, doors, and other points of entry of ash. Lastly, what we have to do after an eruption. Heed authorities' instruction for when it's safe to go back outside or return to your home. Alert family and your friends about the status via text message.
That's all from us, and we end the presentation with this conclusion, and thank you for lending your ears to us.